interesting from the GPU context is a merge sort, and it's really interesting to discuss how to map this efficiently to a GPU, because it's a great instance of a divide-and-conquer approach to the problem. So here's a tree that represents our merge sort, and what's particularly interesting about mapping this to a GPU is that the problem starts off with tons of little tiny parallel problems, and then as the algorithm proceeds, we eventually end up with only one very large problem to solve, and that's the final merge. This is more challenging than many of the algorithms we've discussed, where we have the luxury of being able to solve lots of little parallel problems independently throughout the whole computation. So what we do at each stage of this tree is the same. The only operation that we need is merging two sorted lists together into one sorted list. We begin with n items, which we treat as n sorted one-element lists. Then we run n over 2 merges to create n over 2 sorted two-element lists. Then we run n over 4 merges to create n over 4 sorted four-element lists, and so on. Overall, this is log n stages, and in each stage we merge a total of n elements, so the overall number of operations, the work complexity, is order of n log n. This algorithm exposes a lot of parallelism. Within each step, each individual merge, this merge, this merge, this merge, this merge, and so on, can proceed in parallel. Now, the hard part about mapping this to the GPU is that the number and size of merges we do on each step differs greatly between the first step and the last. So I'm going to talk about a GPU implementation that has three stages. The first stage, this blue stage here, is merging a very large number of very short sequences. Because we have many, many tasks, and each is very small, we might choose to assign one merge to one thread, which can perform each individual merge using a serial algorithm on that thread. We might get better memory coalescing performance if we use shared memory as a staging area to read many input elements or store many output elements at the same time. I'd say it's more common, though, at the start of a large merge sort to just sort a block of elements, say 1024 within shared memory, and then start the merge sort with sorted chunks of size 1024. In other words, if we're actually doing this in practice, we're probably going to use a different algorithm to do this blue stage here with lots of little tiny tasks, and then use merge sort to do the last two stages here. And we're going to see a good algorithm for an in-block sort after we finish the discussion on merge sort. Now we move on to stage two. Now we have lots of small sorted blocks, and we need to merge these small sorted blocks together. On the GPU, for these intermediate merges, we would usually assign one merge to one thread block. Now, the obvious way to merge two sorted sequences is a serial algorithm. So let's take a little bit of a closer look at the algorithm that we'd choose to use here. And we'll come back to this diagram a little bit later. The obvious way to merge two sorted sequences is a serial algorithm. And here's our little serial processor here. The input to this algorithm is two sorted sequences, and the output is one sorted sequence. And so the algorithm is that the serial processor looks at the head of each one of the sorted sequences, chooses whichever element is smaller, outputs it onto the tail of the output sequence, and then advances the input sequence from which he took the previous element. However, this would be a poor match for the GPU because this is a serial algorithm and it wouldn't keep all of our hardware busy. So it's instructive to look at another way, a better way, a more parallel way to merge two sorted sequences.